Good day, I'm your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker, and I'm just here with some more Let's Play This Here Dark Souls Prepare to Die Edition on that there PC, and the frame rate is at 30 now. My computer is no longer panicking about the What? Okay, my computer just decided, because I restarted the recording, that it's fine with the lava now. My computer's weird. My computer is a fucking moody piece of shit. Oh dear, but yes, Dark Souls Prepare to Die Edition. We're running through Lost Izalith. Running through Lost Izalith to try and get to the Bed of Chaos to try and get the final Lord Soul. Or the Twisted Lord. I can't remember what this one's actually called. I think it's called, like, the Warped Lord Soul, the Evil Lord Soul, the fucking Kentucky Fried Lord Soul, I don't know. Corrupt Lord Soul, Twisted Lord Soul, Dark Lord Soul, Lord of the Rings Soul. I don't bloody know. Side note, say hello to what is going to be the primary enemy for the rest of this goddamn area. An army of these fucking things. Oh god, I'm taking more damage than I meant to. Oh dear. Actually, they breathe fire. It would probably be an idea for me to have my stone plate ring on, wouldn't it? So after I've killed these things, I put the stone plate ring on. Yep. There we go. Okay, where's my stone plate? Oh, the flame. Yeah, flame stone plate ring. Slip that on my finger here. While I go a maiming in three. It's like a wombling, but there's considerably more blood. A hunt's just like a ride, except there's blood at the end. Why were you just standing there? Did you not know I was there? Like, I don't. Wait, maybe even the ones that don't attack you are actually alive, and I just couldn't hit that one that was animating in the, I think it was the last video. That could be it. It could easily be it. Come on. Bit of the old butchery. Why did I have so much fucking trouble with this area when I played this the first time? So I'm genuinely just playing them. Just like, why was this area so difficult when I played it first time? Ladies and gentlemen, I give you a living fucking pile of shit. I don't even know what this is. I can't even begin to tell you what that thing is. I genuinely have no idea. I think we are to fight two human foes now. This woman here, skilled with pyromancy, and Kirk. Where are you, Kirk? Okay, Kirk's dead. And so is she. That was quite easy. What do I get from her? Izalith Catalyst, right. I can't actually remember who that woman is. I genuinely don't remember who that is. I think she's one of the witches of Izalith, which would technically make her a giant. Just curiously, that makes her a giant. Also, we're now at the Bed of Chaos. They might be interested, we are not the Bed of Chaos. Bed of Chaos is down here. And I don't particularly care about using my weapon two-handed, because we have to hit it a grand total of three fucking times. This boss may go very quickly. It may I may have a lot of problems with it. Because this boss is really, it's kind of considered really kind of random and bullshit, this boss. I mean, that's how it's considered. Like I said, this boss is somewhat infamous for being one of the most irritating bosses in the game. As I've said before, I didn't really have a problem with it. Because, yep, you see, hit one. Destroy that. Which, well, causes this to happen. Kind of freaky. Creature of living flame back there. Which honestly makes more sense than you'd think. Genuinely makes more sense than at first you'd expect. Especially if you pay attention. If you pay attention to. Jesus. Yeah, no, that's why this boss is considered bullshit.
That's why.
Shit like that. Don't quote me on this, but I seem to recall that the parts of it you've hit. Again, don't quote me on this, I may be entirely wrong. You know, this may be completely incorrect. But there's a little something itching at the back of my brain that tells me that I think the parts of it you destroy stay destroyed. I think that's true. I think that's the truth. Well, you know what I mean. You know what I mean. I think that, you know, once you've hit it once, once you've destroyed one half of it, that half's destroyed forever, which I may be wrong, but for some reason, little voice in my head's telling me that that's the case. Well, we'll find out soon enough. I'm hardly going to have trouble getting back to it, am I? Let's be honest here. Because I'm fighting these things. Yeah, I'm fighting these things, and these things are easy to kill. Yeah, I rip through these things like they were fucking paper over there. As long as I don't miss, I'm fine. I cut through these things like a fucking hot knife through butter. Look at this shit. Harvesting souls left and right. With the grim fucking reaper over here. Okay, admittedly missing there wasn't part of my plan, but then again, I imagine getting basically cut in half wasn't part of his, so there we go. Huh. A single normal swing kills them. These things are kind of pathetic as far as demons go. Then again, I think these things are basically just... Aren't these things basically just like living, fire-breathing statues? Isn't that... That's what these are, isn't it, basically? Fire-breathing statues? That move with a mechanism I genuinely don't understand. Oh, no, wait, that's why that thing was animating. The statues float around a bit. Okay. Even the basic statue ones actually animate a bit. I understand now. I see, said the blind man. Oh, my God, it's covered in fucking eyes. Fuck. That thing's terrifying. It really is. It's fucking awful. Isn't that impressive looking? Sometimes when you look up in Dark Souls and you just look at the sky, it's Jesus. Terrifying. Well, not terrifying, awe-inspiring. You end up awestruck when you see like the ceilings or something. Okay, well no, if I was telling the truth or talking out my ass when we get down here. Nope, I was telling the truth. Okay. If I remember rightly, if you stick to the very side over here, the floor won't go out from under you. Until that point. Okay, we have to run around on the inside. But I suppose at the very least running around the very edge in that way, at the very least it revealed... It revealed where the floor goes out from under you. I don't like being this close to its massive fucking gnashing claw. Oh, shit. Oh, jeez. Glug, come on, Glug! Excellent! Sweet! Excellent, stabbed it, cool. Yeah. Now it's got another fucking freaky flailing fire hand. Okay. Oh, God. Look, please. Ah, Jesus. For fuck. Let me through. Ow. Glug, please. The floor should... Yep, there it is. We just need to get past here, because we can't actually hurt it. Wait, how the fuck do we get over there? Oh, no, wait, I think we have to fall into that hole, don't we? Yeah, we do. We have to just fall onto the platform. Give me a minute. There we go. Take a quick look. Okay, apparently that fire can't... Apparently that fire didn't hurt us. Okay. In fact, at this point, I think this enemy... I think this boss fight is over. This boss fight, I don't think... this boss can't hurt us anymore. Because this... is the bed of chaos. Oh no, wait, it can still hurt us. Shit. Let's just kill it. Single swing. But yeah, I believe that that is, I believe that that's actually what all that was left of, you know, the witch of Izalith. I believe that was all that was left. Let's read her Lord Soul. Yeah, so. The soul of the bed of chaos and mother of all demons. The Lord Soul was found. The Witch of Izalith attempted to duplicate the first flame from a soul, but instead created a distorted being of chaos and fire. Its power formed a bed of life, which would become the source of all demons and is more than enough to satiate the Lord of Izalith. Yeah. That's what that was. Bye, Link. Okay, so, what do we have to do? What do we have left to do? Well, we've killed all of the lords. So, we've killed the lords, I think all we actually have left to do now is, all that we have left I said I was going to do is, the Painted World of Ariamis, and then complete the game. So, there we are, dangerously close to completing this Let's Play, ladies and gentlemen. I might actually just keep going until I've completed it. I'm not sure. It depends on how much resistance the Painted World of Ariamis puts up. Let us sink more points into dexterity, so we can do more damage. And let us warp. Actually, no. Let us. Okay, I've already prepared my equipment. Let us reinforce my armor. The Twinkling Titanite. And now let us warp to the Dark Moon Tomb. It's bizarre just how much the Dark Moon. It's just how much the Dark Moon colours are actually replicated in Artorias' armour. Do I have what I need to progress? Peculiar doll, peculiar doll, peculiar doll. Yep. Because you need the peculiar doll in order to get into the Painted World of Ariamis. And just a little... Don't want to use the phrase FYI, but it's the only thing I think of at the moment. Just a little FYI. If you want to go into the Painted World of Ariamis, you'd best be prepared because you have to complete the area before you can't warp out, you can't walk back out. Because the idea of the place is that it seals you in. So yeah, so be prepared, basically. When you go into the Painted World, that best be your intention. You best be planning on completing the Painted World. A yellow painting guardian. You must be intending on completing it when you go in, basically. I actually didn't know the painting guardians were still here in Twilight and Orlando. Everything else leaves, but they stay. That's a thing, actually. Where the hell did the rest of them go? You know what? Nah, fuck you guys. I'm gonna activate the cutscene, fuck you people. Yep, we're being swallowed by the Painted World, ladies and gentlemen. Yep. We've been eaten by the Painted World of Ariamis. We've got precisely one humanity to see us through. Which is great, which means we're probably going to end up doing a lot of this with five Estus flasks. Because I just don't have the humanity to afford. So let's just activate this bonfire. Sit at it. There is a black phantom here, but I don't particularly want to be fighting it. The painted world is primarily dreglings and variations on dreglings. These things are almost certainly not called dreglings, but I call them dreglings because fuck you. But yeah, that's the painted world's. Just a minute. So I just. Huh, that worked. Sorry, the frame rate was acting up a bit, so I decided to stop and start the recording. Hi. Yeah, dreglings. It's all dreglings, a couple of crow enemies. Some enemies that are very reminiscent of the phalanx enemies from Demon Souls in the courtyard down there. Oh, and these things, but as I said, variations on dreglings. These things make you toxic. It's very irritating. Unless you hit them with fire, however, I don't actually have any fire weapons. I was kind of hoping that this shield would protect me from that, but apparently not! I may end up having to fucking fight the final boss of this area full of toxins. We're probably just gonna have to fight this area full of toxins. And yes, I am somewhat rushing through the painted world. I will admit that. I'm not picking up... Like, there are a lot of really good items in the painted world, if you're interested. Like, seriously, just stop. If you want the items, just stop and look around, basically. There is an undead dragon at the end of this bridge. We want to set off this undead dragon, and then back the fuck up. Back the fuck up. Because it moves at quite a speed. And I don't actually know how difficult this thing's going to be to kill. Oh, okay, that was not a good idea. Walking headfirst into the undead dragon. Not a good plan. I think maybe hacking at its claws is a plan, I don't know. Yeah, attack at its claws, shall we? It's actually doing... Oh, that is... Oh, hello. Can I get away? I don't think I can get away with hacking its face. Can I? No. Just fuck it. Keep hacking at the claws. Keep hacking at the claws because we have to hack it. We have to kill this thing. We have to kill this thing in order to get at the boss of the area. Fuck. Glug, come on. Glug, glug. It's nearly dead. Look how little health it's got. It's nearly dead. I don't really have to worry about its breath, because I'm fairly certain it's just spewing toxic at us. And, you know, I'm kind of already, you know, sick. You know, I'm already kind of sick as a parrot with toxic. Is it dead? It's dead. What do I feel like I'm speedrunning this area? Do I have... I'm fairly certain I don't have, but do I... No, I don't. Oh, well. Maybe it dropped some. What do you... I don't know. You can hope. Nope, it dropped the dragon scale. Because it's a dragon. Is that another one? That's another one, isn't it? Can I actually... Can I kill this? Or what? what's happening here? No, I'm being serious. What's going on, man? What is this? What is this thing? Huh. If it wasn't for the fact I'm currently dying of the Lurgy, I'd look that up, see what the fuck's going on here. I don't remember that. I mean, you know, I can fully believe there's another one, but... Just a fucking lump of flesh just sitting there? Sounds like... I think that might be bugged. I hope I'm not bugged, but I think that might be a bug. Well, since I've just kind of got to wait for my plague to clear up, I might as well just go and explore. Oh look, it's the enemy that's reminiscent of the Phalanx. Like, literally, this is basically the Phalanx enemies. Wait, were the enemies called the Phalanx, or was it just the boss that was called the Phalanx? I genuinely don't know. Yeah, I think... Although, actually, I could also say that these things are a variety of Dregling as well, because look at them. Don't they look like... They look like Dreglings to me. They've got, like, the same kind of skin texture. I think they've even got the same head. Wait, am I killing them by hitting them in the face? Is the hit detection off? Because these guys are supposed to... If I remember rightly, these dudes are supposed to basically take no damage if you hit them in the face. What the fuck? I'm hitting them full on in the face and they're dying. This is weird. They shouldn't be dying like this. That's the Phalanx enemy, ladies and gentlemen. Can we open this? It's locked. You see, once this clears up, once my toxic clears up, I'll actually be able to, you know, check and see what's going on with that undead dragon, but... Well, that fucking... Yeah, that undead dragon. See what's going on, but at the moment, there's nothing really I can do right now, you know? I've just kind of got to... kind of hang out. Maybe it's because I'm trying to run through. Maybe if I actually do some of the other stuff you're supposed to do, like... I remember I actually did this place before I did the Tomb of the Giants. So this is actually the first place I saw these wheels when I played it myself. It kicked my ass. So I didn't get what they were, and I didn't have a great shield. Oh my god, I'm dead. But you know what that does? That gives me one damn good excuse to look up what the hell's going on with the, Give me one damn good way to actually check to see what's going on with that dragon. Give me a minute. Okay, looked it up. Apparently, it's a fairly common bug. And apparently, what you have to do in order to get past it is this. Just do that at it, and it stands up. Because apparently, it's literally the back legs of the undead dragon. That the back legs just chose not to move. Because apparently that's just a thing that happens. Sometimes the back legs... You know, haven't you ever seen that? Sometimes the back legs of you... Sometimes your back legs just refuse to move. Doesn't that happen to you? No. Because that's weird. That's really fucking strange. Oh, dear. Okay. Let's actually equip the fire bombs. See about... just dying. Give me some health back, please. But yeah, you cook the firebombs, because to see if this will actually help me get past those things when I'm getting toxic up to the eyeballs. Because I don't want to be toxic up to the eyeballs, you know? Okay. Firebomb. Okay, no, I'm just gonna get toxic to the eyeballs, not already. Oh, unless I just roll away, apparently. Maybe it's just if I avoid actually being in the fucking... Okay, I'm just gonna try throwing fire at it, and then hitting it. See if that does anything. Okay, so from the looks of it, it appears just as long as I don't get hit by... As long as I throw fire at it first. Okay. I'm okay. I'm cool with that. I'll accept that. Oh, not! No, it was the rolling away. Okay. No, I get it. I get it. That's a fucking swallow of humanity. Oh, you! Fuck off! Breathing toxic at me, how dare you? Wait, how was I just damaged by it breathing toxic at me? I shouldn't be able to be damaged by something breathing toxic at me when I'm already toxicked up to the eyeballs. Okay, fuck it, let's see how this works. This doesn't work, I'm gonna cry. I'm being serious, aren't I? Is the arse of that thing the leaping demon? Are you fucking kidding? The arse of that thing is the leaping dragon. Okay. Have I managed to sneak my way past a fucking evil knight of Berenike? I think I've. Okay, normally there's a knight of Berenike on here, but. Okay, apparently I just got past that. Hi. This is the crossbreed Priscilla. She's a boss monster.
Who art thou? One of us thou art not. If thou hast misstepped into this world, plunge down from the plank and hurry home. If thou seekest I, thine desires shall be requited not.
Yeah, we can literally just leave.
Thou must return this I.
Oh, we can do this. And fight her, and if I remember rightly, you can actually see her footsteps. She's there! She's like directly in front of us right now. Fuck's sake. For fuck's sake, can I get a fucking glug here? You're invisible, love. You think you'd at the very least be kind enough to give me to let me get a glug in edgeways. Come on.
I expected as much from thee. Why dost thee hurry toward thine death?
And I died from toxic. You know what? You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna run through this fucking place. Just gonna start running. I am literally just gonna run. I'm just gonna run. Fuck fighting things. You know, I'm just trying to get to a boss. You know, actually, no. I can, you know, I'm gonna kill you two. Because fuck you guys. I wish my controller didn't sometimes act as if I'd let go of B. That's a weird thing. You know, some of the more attentive of you watch these have probably noticed that sometimes when I'm running, sometimes I will just kind of stop when I've still got stamina. The reason for that is because sometimes my controller just acts as if I've let go of B. I don't know why, it's just a thing my controller does sometimes. Only does it in Dark Souls as well. Such a very strange bug. Okay, I can't outrun arrows. That's I was trying to outrun an arrow, so probably wasn't the best idea. Is she gonna be hostile to me? Yep, she's automatically hostile to me. Shit. And basically what you've got to do for this fight is just try and keep track of her fucking footsteps. Ah, bastard. God. She's behind me. She's that! You know what? I don't care enough. I just don't care. Where are your feet? Fuck this, I'm fuck it, I'm going. What? Fucking what? That's the way out! Does that just stop being the way out? Fuck this. Oh my god. Yeah, I know you're there. What the fuck? I'm so very sick. Okay, she's like right there. She's right there. Okay, so she's right there. Okay, I've hit her. I'm fucking walking into her. Hi. She's not difficult to avoid. She's just a bitch to catch. Oh, what the? A fucking blow kisses at me. Apparently, Priscilla was originally going to be a kind of heroine character for this game. She's dead now. Your soul, I'm afraid. Excellent, twin humanity is just alright. Yum. Okay. Eat your soul. Eat these souls. Take a glug. Now, can I get out of the world by... Okay, now I can get out of the painted world. Okay. Apparently, you just can't do it if you've aggroed her. Well, you know what? Fair enough. I know I got really angry, but fair enough. Okay, right. We killed the crossbreed Priscilla. Next time, what time is it, actually? Let me check. Jesus, like 8. But yeah, so... Oh.
You died.
Yeah, because that's entirely different to running off. To running off the edge, isn't it? Yep. Hi. Okay, fuck. Get out of here. But yeah, so I'm going to cut out. And next time, we are going to march towards the kiln of the first flame and finish this once and for all. But that's going to have to be all for me for now. I've been your humble Red Sardis Thinker. And as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. You know, it only just occurred to me. I don't think we're ever actually going to see what happens to Solaire because I think I just avoided it. Well, look it up. You can look it up. If there's anything I don't show, you can always just look it up. You know, there's a lot of stuff about Dark Souls out there.